Senator Romero.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Let me just say, this is my first time sitting on this committee, and I thank you for accepting me as a member, and want to applaud your leadership on this issue. Just from the time that we've been in here, from the documents that your committee and staff so capably prepared, in answer to the question that you've asked, is physician peer review a broken system? As a new member listening to this, I'd have to say yes. And I'm eager to get on to what the next steps may be from what I have seen. And I think this is so important because there's probably no other profession that comes so close to being godlike. I mean, this is life and death. When we think about who most closely resembles the power of God, it's you. It's physicians. So I'm disturbed by, of course, the materials that you provided us to the backdrop. I'm looking forward to seeing, not getting beyond the yes or no, is it broken? I believe that it is. But we do have, I think, steps and immediate steps that are needed to get to cut to the chase and find out how do we respond. Dr. Lowen, you indicated it depends on the institution, what they send forward. I'm scratching my head thinking, how can that be? And to a large extent, the culture is set from the top. I know you review, but there's also the question I guess I would ask is, where's the oversight? And where is the, what is the incentive given again as Senator, I was about to say Dr. Weiland, but Senator Weiland pointed out there can be competition issues here. Again, do I want my name in the field to be the premier person on whatever, Octomoms or whatever it may be, or versus somebody else? So there are so many issues, I think, beyond even the practice, but the ethics of it as well, that I'm looking forward to learning. And I think, Senator McLeod, you've hit on an issue that is really long past due in us providing more oversight.
Thank you. Senator Aniston.
While I appreciate Senator Romero's remarks of wanting to get on, I don't think, however, that we've answered the basic question, is it broken? I think the question really is, how broken is it? And I guess my question is to the Lumina folks. I'm reading the report, absolutely agree with most of the report, but one would put the report down saying the whole peer review system is broken, it's failed, and we need to start from scratch. I'm not so sure that that's needed, and I'm not so sure it's possible. Having served on my surgery monitor committee and actually been involved with peer review for a couple of decades, having to discipline physicians and in the surgery department and the anesthesia department especially, I can tell you that oftentimes it works just fine. And I guess in my first question to the Lumina folks is, did you find that? Is your report an all or nothing report? Does the entire system have to be, we have to look at it, but are there not good parts? For example, let me just tell you, I can think of any one meeting where we might be talking about five or six physician complaints that are ongoing. Out of those five or six, four or five of them were handled fine just within the local hospital group in the status quo. One didn't or wasn't and would prompt the Dr. Lowe's and the medical boards of the world having to get involved. Is there anything in your report, however, that indicates that we don't necessarily have to reinvent the system, that we just have to fix it? I don't know if I made myself clear.
I think that, as we mentioned, the thing that's so good about this system are the people in the system. The doctors, I had one physician tell me, I lie awake at night worrying that I have missed something and it will harm patients or doctors. I have had attorneys beg me to try to change the system because it is so flawed, it does not work. And you would think, well, attorneys, they really are trying to do the very best for their clients that they can. I had one attorney say to me, I am committing malpractice if I don't have my organization slow down that 805 process as much as they can or avoid it altogether. It is my job to keep them from filing 805 reports. So I think that what is broken is the system. Are there good parts in it? Oh, of course. Of course there are some things that work. But I think there is an overwhelming number of things that don't.
Okay. My next question is based on cost. I was looking at your PowerPoint. Costs can be as much as $100,000 to the hospital or the entity that's doing the peer review, maybe another $100,000. If you look at the doctor's times involved, the volunteer work, very expensive, and yet you're calling for independent outside review on virtually every peer review complaint that's brought up in the hospital or peer review finding. How can anybody afford that?
The report does outline some ways that could be funded. One of the things that this would do, an independent organization, would provide for a more objective process so that a physician was not reviewed by people that they directly work with and may depend on and may depend on them. The practice of medicine is a group effort, as we all know today, and I'm being asked to review friends that I spend the weekends with. I'm being asked to review people that I cannot stand the sight of. And that's a human thing to not be able to let that affect you. So I think the independence of an organization doing peer review is paramount from that perspective. But I do think that we can tax some of the people involved, not the taxpayers, tax used in the sense like UC uses it, take a percentage of some malpractice cases, some attorney fees, some other sources of income. I think that this system needs to be made to work in order to provide quality and safety for patients in hospitals, but also in these ambulatory care settings, in medical groups, in clinics, whether the people are have insurance and money or not.
Dr. Lowe, I'm going to ask you to take off your medical board hat and go back to being a cardiologist like you were 15 years ago on the night that you did my angioplasty. And thank you very much. I don't know if I properly said thank you, although I did pay my bill. But you've been involved in peer review on the local level in your hospital and in your medical society. Would you agree with the concept that virtually every case has to go to outside independent review?
Oh, absolutely not. I mean, there are all levels of alert that we have to be alert about. And I mean, you know, some of those peer review things are just behavioral cases. I mean, we can just do some counseling and some, wellness committee work and so forth and so on. Not every case is a breach of care, but in cases where there's a risk to the public, I think those cases will necessarily go to some higher level of peer review. And the medical board is very focused on having an objective review by using outside reviewers that are educated on the process of review, whereas in hospital systems, the people doing the review may not understand all the technical aspects of a peer review.
Can you, just off the top of your head, and I know it's an educated guess, how many cases of peer review have you seen outside of the medical board since before you got onto the medical board? How many cases of the peer review complaints that you would see on a month-to-month basis working in your hospital over the last couple of decades do you feel needed to go on to a higher level of independent peer review? Can you give a percentage, a guess?
Again, that's a very complicated issue. The issue about going to an outside reviewer is more in terms of ethics and transparency and, lack of conflict of interest. That's what they're addressing, lack of conflict of interest. But, in quality institutions, these cases are very infrequent because the standard is set so high for the care within that institution that these things just aren't allowed to happen. So they just don't happen. If you set the bar very high for your hospital, bad things don't happen. So I would say, you know, one or two cases a year from maybe any large institution or less.
I appreciate that. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. I think we should move on. We've spent almost an hour. But I think for any of the public that is listening to this, I don't want anybody to mistake that because it's costly or because of conflict of interest or anything, that bad mistakes are going to be overlooked because we can't do it because it's just too costly. I just want the public to understand that we do have the medical board and we do have other areas that would, in all likelihood, cover something. I just don't want monetary issue to be the only thing that people are hearing that we don't do it because it's too costly.